eat something.
You're right, this is stupid. Go. I said go, not stop.
Still nothing, sir.
Wonderful.
Wallace and Teager in the patrol car. Dante and
Detective.
De Palma
relax,
out of the
relax.
Room.
Reach out for Hoffman.
Detective.
Burnett, get him down here.
I thought
sure,
we were...
Sure.
Get the 12 gauge out of my car. Now!
First up tonight, another cable favorite from my youth. You know, I love watching these old movies, especially now that my kid's like old enough to watch an R-rated movie. I won't show them like, you know, Man Bites Dog or Henry Portrait of a Serial Killer or something like that, but I'll love to watch all these really cheesy horror movies I used to watch all the time on HBO. Tonight, personal favorite, Night of the Creeps, directed by Fred Decker, who had one of the greatest 1-2 punches ever when he directed this and he directed Monster Club, which has yet to come out on DVD. That movie should have a DVD release. This one doesn't have a DVD release either. And I'm sure if you're around, you know, if you're like 16, 17, 18 and had HBO back in the day, 86 is when this came out, then you remember this one. It starred the kid who played Rusty on the European Vacation movie. He took over for Anthony Michael Hall, so you'll know him right away. He's got red hair. He looks all goofy. And his buddy who's like on crutches and stuff and like limps through the whole movie and gets caught by some alien slugs. And it's got Tom Atkins in it, who was a John Carpenter favorite. He was in Halloween 3. He was in Escape from New York. This movie's full of faces that you look at and you're like, hey, I remember that guy. Then you got to go on like IMDb or something to look him up because you have no idea where you've seen him before. Then you go, oh yeah, it's a dude from European Vacation. This one concerns, well, it's got like these two storylines that kind of go together. First, you have this guy who, Tom Atkins, when he was younger, his girlfriend got chopped up by some axe-wielding maniac whose corpse was brought back to life by aliens who came down with these slugs that get in your brains and like possess you. And it's all dumb. It's sci-fi hokum at its best, you know. So you got like heads splitting open. You got possessed dogs and cats who attack their owners. And you have, this is the one thing that really annoys me in these movies, though, because I think they're being oh so clever. They give everybody like director last names. Like there's one guy whose last name is Carpenter and one whose last name is Cronenberg and stuff like that. Come on. It's not that funny, people. You know, we've seen the movies. We get the jokes. We don't need these goofy little... It's funny when you do it like in Creepshow, when you have the thing box, you know, down there from Antarctica, and it's kind of like a sly little in-joke that only the cool kids are going to get. But when you got to throw in like Carpenter and Cronenberg, it's just lame. So drop that, please. It's so Scream. It's so whatever, blah, blah, blah. We don't need it. But it's 86. I'll forgive them. If I saw it now, I'd be pissed. I'd take away an automatic star. But this one, luckily, has all kind of gore, plus it has like fraternity guys get killed in drunk driving bus accidents and then get possessed by aliens, walk around like zombies and attacking sorority girls. And unfortunately, there's only one soapy shower scene, but you get to see some nice boobs, so it has that going for it. I made my kid turn away during that part, just so you know. I don't need any child welfare services come breathing down my neck or anything like that. I made him turn away. I was the only one that could watch the boobs, and I watched it only to do this review. I did not enjoy it, not one bit. But this one, still out on videotape. You can find it used. I found a used copy for like $5, you know, one day, just happened upon it in a video store. But of course, my videotape is like wearing down because I've seen it so many times. So please release this on DVD. Release this. Release the Monster Squad. Jeez, see, I'm screwing up. Monster Club's a totally different movie. Don't even listen to me. Just watch it.